Just remember, it really does not matter where you study. The most important thing in the construction industry, I think and I believe, is your experience and also how well you do wherever you study. Hello everybody, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Nothando and I make videos on construction, lifestyle and travel. If you're new here, welcome, and if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for tuning back in. Please do not forget to drink water because yes, she's. Anyway, on today's video, we are going to talk about universities within South Africa that offer the course, the quantity surveying course, or relevant, that's how they call it. So construction studies, construction management, construction economics, depending on where you study. I hope that I have all the universities on this list. And if not, if I missed a university, please comment down below. I'll also link all the universities in the description. So if you're interested or if you feel like you qualify for one more than the other, you can just go through the different links in the description of this video. So yeah, let's get into the video. This is in no particular order. First on the list, I have the University of Pretoria. The University of Pretoria is located in Pretoria, which is the capital city of South Africa. It was established in 1908 and offers a BSc degree in quantity surveying, and then you can also go higher, I think, for an honors and all of that. The requirements for the University of Pretoria is an APS score of 30 points, excluding life orientation, and the subjects that are really focused on or looked at are physics or accounting, and you need a level 4 for it, maths you need a level 5, and English you need a level 5 for it. In Pretoria, we have Tshwane University of Technology. Tshwane University of Technology is actually a merger of various other universities. I forgot them. I'll list them here. Tshwane University of Technology was established in 2004, but prior to that, it was Pretoria Technikon, and it was a merger of other universities to make it Tshwane University of Technology. Tshwane University of Technology was founded in 2004. It is located in Pretoria and it offers a BTEC in quantity surveying. It wasn't clear what the APS was for the admission of the course, so if you do know, please look at it in the description. University of Johannesburg. The University of Johannesburg was established in 2005, but it is actually much older than that. It is a merger between Rand Afrikaans University, Wits Technikon, and Vista University. It is located in Johannesburg, South Africa, and offers a BTEC in quantity surveying. It has 4 campuses, and you need an APS of 30 points in order for you to qualify for the course. And the subjects that are focused on are physics or accounting with a level 5, maths with a level 5, and English with a level 4. The University of the Witwatersrand, which is located in Bramfontein, Johannesburg. It was established in 1922 and offers a BSc in quantity surveying / construction management / construction studies. So in order for you to qualify for this course, you need an APS of 36 points, and the subjects that are focused on are maths with a level 5 and English with a level 5, and then all the other subjects you can kind of choose and pick however you want, but your APS needs to add to 36 points. The University of Cape Town. This is the oldest university on the list, actually. It was established in 1829 and it is located in the mother city. The requirements for this is a national certificate endorsed for a degree. You need to write an NBT test, which is a national benchmark test. However, I've seen that there's some changes after COVID. Or during COVID, I'm not sure if you still need to do it now, but it's on the list. The subjects that they focus on are maths with a level 5 and English with a level 5, and also satisfactory NBT test results. Next on the list, we have the Nelson Mandela Metropolitan University. I hope I'm saying it right. This one was established in 2005 and it is located in the coastal city of, formerly known as Port Elizabeth, now known as Gqeberha. The degree here actually comes in different qualification brackets. So you can do a diploma, an advanced diploma, and degree. For each of the different courses, they can take different qualifications. So if you want to do a degree, you need a higher APS score. And if you want to do a diploma, you need a lower APS score. Just to know the intricacies of it, just go through the website and you'll see exactly what your APS needs to be for your specific degree of choice. The University of KwaZulu-Natal, which is a merger between the University of Natal and the University of Durban-Westville. It was established in 2004. It's obviously much older, but as soon as they merged, it kind of like starts afresh. They offer a BSc, Quantity Surveying or Construction Management, and you need an APS of 33 points, with maths being a level 5, English being a level 5, and LO being a level 4. They actually do count LO here. University of the Free States, which was established in 1904. It is located in Bloemfontein, and it offers a BSc in Quantity Surveying. In order for you to qualify to study at the University of the Free State, you need an APS of 32, with maths being 5, accounting or physics being a level 4, and English being a level 4. The duration for the course at the University of Free State is 4 years. They also have something interesting on there, like you need to be a minimum of age 23, and you need to be fully employed in the construction industry. I'm not sure if this is still a thing. If you studied or are studying at the University of the Free State, please do let me know if this is a thing, because I find it so odd. Like, how are you going to get a job in the construction industry? Like, I found it interesting. I'm just like, maybe it's for people who just want to, who have experience but just want to qualify and put back up the experience. It was kind of interesting to me. So yeah, these are all the universities that I could find. If I left something out, please do let me know it down in the comments. Just remember, it really does not matter where you study. The most important thing in the construction industry, I think and I believe, is your experience, and also how well you do wherever you study. Research all the universities as much as you can. Apply to as many as you can or can afford to apply, because I know there's sometimes like an application fee. And yeah, wherever you study, just focus on doing the best that you can while you're studying where you're studying. So yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. Surprisingly, I get a lot of DMs about subject choices and where to study. So this is for you. Thank you so much for watching. See you later in another video. Please don't forget to like. You don't have to subscribe anymore. Thanks. Subscribe. Thanks. Bye.